Hey, so Mr. Field, we're going to talk here about how to subtract integers. We watched the previous video, how to add integers. Here we're going to subtract, and I'm going to show it on the number line and with integer tiles. Now, in the last video, we used the cool little square ones. This time, we're going to use round ones. It doesn't matter. You just need to view a positive and a negative tile. Whether they're square or round really doesn't matter a whole lot. Now, our first problem is 5 minus 3, and that's super easy. We'll show it with our little yellow tiles because these are positive, and we have 5 yellows, that's positive 5, and when we subtract 3, we just take away 3, and that leaves us with positive 2. We can see this on our number line model as well. We have 5, this is always our starting number on the number line. We have 5, and we already know when we subtract, we go to the left on our number line. That's this way, and so we just go left 3 places, 1, 2, and 3, and our answer is positive 2, just like we said it was. We knew this already from the tiles. Now, you're probably thinking, why would I use the tiles if I like the number line, or why would I use the number line if I like the tiles? The tiles and the number line each work better than the other for different kinds of subtraction problems, and it's important that you have both of those models in your head. All right, here we go, next problem, 3 minus 5. Okay, so we're going to start with 3 yellows. We'll start here on our number line at 3. Now, the number line, I think, is a better model this time. So what the 3 says here is that this is where I'm starting. So this is my starting number. I like to underline it sometimes. And I already know when I subtract, I'm going to go this way. So I'm going to go 5 places to my left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'm confused as to what that is because I don't know what numbers lie this way. So let's count down. This is 2, 1, 0. This is negative 1. This is negative 2, so my answer is negative 2, not positive 2, but negative 2. Okay, but let's see how this works with tiles. I have 3 tiles here, and I want to take away 5, but I don't have 5 to take away. Well, you may recall from earlier that a yellow and red together make a 0 pair. This is positive 1 plus negative 1, and that makes 0. And I can add 0 to something all day long, and it doesn't change it. So this number right here is still 3. See, because it's 1, 2, 3 plus 0. And this number is still 3. The difference is now I can take 5 away. So when I take 5 away from this, 5 yellows, 5 positives, I'm left with 2 reds, which is 2 negatives. So my answer is still negative 2. Cool. Kind of easy once you think about it. In other words, if you don't have enough stuff to take away, you have to put them in, but you have to put them in 0 pairs. All right, let's start with negative 2 minus 3. Now, again, I think the number line model is a pretty good one here. We're going to start on negative 2. Because that's our starting number. And we're going to subtract 3. Just like last time, I know that when I subtract, I go left. 1, 2, 3. Now, it's important that you understand the number line. So a lot of you still like to draw the number line with every number in creation on it, and that's fine. But a lot of us are ready now to just say, okay, well, that's negative 3, negative 4, that's negative 5. So negative 2 minus 3 is negative 5. And the way I view this in my head is I start on negative 2, and if I'm subtracting 3, I'm just going even further negative. So that's going to give me a minus 5, or negative 5. Here's how it looks on paper. Here's negative 2. I want to take 3 away from this, but there aren't 3 yellows here that I can take away. So I need to put my 3 yellows in. But I can't just put 3 yellows in, I have to put 3 0 pairs in. Now I can take my 3 yellows away, and that leaves me with negative 5. So the answer is still negative 5, just like I thought it was. Negative 4 minus 3. Looks kind of sloppy. Okay. The reason I chose this, it's a lot like this previous problem, but 4 is bigger than 3, so a lot of times we have some ideas about how we want this to go. But negative 4 is here on our number line, and just like last time, when I subtract 3, I go 3 places to the left. 1, 2, 3. That's negative 4, negative 5, negative 6, negative 7. Okay. Again, my mental picture of this is I have negative 4. When I subtract, I go even further negative. Okay. Let's look at this on the tiles. Here's negative 4. I want to subtract positive 3. I don't have positive 3, so I need to put it in. But I can't just put it in. I have to put 0 in. There's our 0. Now I can take 3 away, leaves me with negative 7. If this seems like it's going too fast, you're welcome to pause this, rewind this, all you want until this sits well in your head. Okay? Here's 5 minus negative 3. Now this is a little tricky. Now all of a sudden we're having to subtract negatives. Okay? 5 minus negative 3. Let's look at this on the number line. Here's 5. And I've known all my life that when I subtract, I go to the left. There's a difference here, though. I'm subtracting a negative number, and negatives are just always the opposite of everything. So instead of going left, I'm going to go right. 3 places. 1, 2, 3. You might say, well, I know 3 places to the right of 5. That's 8. It sure is. Or 7, or 6. Okay? So it's really like 5 plus 3. Here's what it looks like on tiles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I want to take negative 3 away from this, but there isn't negative 3 there. I need 3 reds there to take away. So I'm going to put them there. But I can't just put them there. That changes my number. So I'm going to put a 0 pair there. Okay? Now I can take negative 3 away. Leaves me with positive 8. Okay? There's another way of looking at this, and a lot of people just say, add a line, change the sign. You can add a line and change subtraction to addition, and then we just add here. So really, any subtraction problem is really just adding the opposite. So 4 minus 3 is the same as, negative 4 minus 3 is the same as negative 4 plus negative 3. Negative 2 minus 3 is negative 2 plus negative 3. 3 minus 5 is really 3 plus negative 5. And 5 minus 3 is really 5 plus negative 3. Why you would ever want to change 5 minus 3 to something that's more difficult, no one knows. Okay, our last problem, negative 4 minus negative 3. Here's negative 4 on the number line, and I know this is minus, and I know that minus means go this way. But I'm subtracting a negative number, so it means turn around and go the other direction. So 1, 2, 3. So this is negative 3, negative 2, negative 1. Negative 4 minus negative 3 equals negative 1. If I do my add a line, change the sign, that's negative 4 plus positive 3, and that's negative 1, I know from my addition facts. But let's try negative 4 minus negative 3, and I think you may find that this is an easier one with tiles. Let me rewrite the problem. This is negative 4 minus negative 3. Okay, here's negative 4. I want to take negative 3 away from it. Leaves me with negative 1. Hey, that's what my answer was. This is one of those that looks really difficult, and it really turns out to be much, much easier with the tiles. When you take a negative away from a negative, you're really just taking some away from the reds. Here's another example. Negative 3 minus negative 4. Okay. Here's negative 3 on my number line. Now when I go negative 4, I know to subtract, I go this way, but I'm subtracting a negative, so I'm going to go this way. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's negative 2, negative 1, 0, positive 1. Let's see how that works with my tiles. I have negative 3 to start with. I want to take negative 4 away, but there aren't 4 negatives there to take away. But now there are when I throw in a 0 pair. Now I can take 4 negatives away, leaves me with 1 positive. And that's the answer, positive 1. Okay, and we can add a line, change the sign to see that that's just negative 3 plus positive 4, which is also positive 1. That's how we subtract integers. Good luck with it. Hope you do well on your assignment, and looking forward to our next video.